Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Behind the Closed Doors. And today you're gonna see the ISE. Now what is the ISE? It's a large trade show in the Netherlands with a video, audio, a home theater, and whatnot more. And of course, we're gonna take a look at some of the interesting products there. So join us for today's episode of Behind the Closed Doors. If you like what we do, subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, and of course, smash that like button. But most of all, also check out our Patreon site because we have a lot of good stuff on there. Let's go. Okay, all parking spaces at the Rai were full. We're now about 11 kilometers away. And look at this, how tight everything is. How many cars can you fit on one parking lot? Well, just stack them together. Okay, let's go to the Rai for the ISE. Okay, arrived at the Rai. Very busy. And now I have to get in. Luckily, we already have cards. And of course, Blackmagic is also here. And of course, because it's also a trade show for audio, you can see some really cool design speakers. I don't know how they sound, but they look interesting. And here you actually see a whole floor just about smart boards, and this is of course where the future is going, also for schools, or where it actually already is. But here you can see the newest developments on those smart boards on which you can draw and put presentations on. Really cool stuff if you're into that. And interactive distance learning solutions. This would be cool for digital classroom, actually. Look like a really interesting product. The only problem is that nobody on the booth actually spoke very well English. So I still don't know what it does, but hey, it's there are more suppliers here, of course, but we're looking for something that actually auto-tracks during digital classroom. And that looked really nice, but well, if you can't understand what it does, next manufacturer. Okay, on our way to JVC to look at some of their new projectors. So here they actually project on several modules and they use a robot as a backdrop, but it's an interesting technique. So they use an Epson projector. Cool. So by now you already know full HD, 4K of course, but what about 16K, 60p's? Well, let's take a look at this one. So here we see 8K. And over there, 16K. How much resolution do you need? Well, 16K. And a very fast computer and big hard drives. And arrived at the JVC booth. With a really cool lineup of projectors from home theater to slightly smaller, and of course, really big. And if you like buttons and sliders and other stuff, you're in heaven. I don't know what it all does, but there must be an exit button somewhere. and 3 computers, of course, to steer everything. And the drone area, where they demonstrate drones, especially, of course, for video. Now, this might be interesting for some of you guys. Here we have some wireless 20 hours DMX app controlled and IP65 lighting. So not something that we're going to use for photography, but hey, I'm just going to show you guys because it might be of some interest to some of you. And the brand is, I hope I pronounced it correct, Astera. We love wireless stuff. Now, of course, we all love big screens, right? And I'm sure that this doesn't capture the quality you see, but this is really amazing. Look at this. And trust me, the colors are incredibly vibrant. It's unbelievable. And there's a lot of three-dimensionality in this screen. This is absolutely awesome. I'm not easily impressed by big screens, but I never saw something like this. Wow. Think about playing video games on this. It's not designed for it, but wow. Call of Duty. Yep. And don't we just all hate all those remotes? Well, Crestel now is something to fight for. And of course, you know Crestel from all the home automation stuff. So that they actually have a remote control can be pretty interesting. And here they are in real life. Looks pretty cool. The only problem, they just told me, it only works if you own a Crestel system. And those are pretty expensive. So it's not really something that you buy to replace all your remotes. That's still the area of Hyrule, which actually now stopped to exist. And of course, Logitech. But it sure does look nice. Now, with all the new 4K projectors and, of course, in the future 8K, you also want bigger screens. Because let's be honest, 4K is not really designed for smaller TV screens. You need it big. So you need a big screen. So watch this. The Extensia. A really big tap tension screen, specially designed for 4K and higher. Up to 16K, so it's a really big screen. It doesn't fit our house, but hey, that's another problem. And of course, we also have something called the Wife Appreciation Factor, the WAF Factor. And that's actually where Projecta comes in with a new screen that actually mounts flush to your ceiling. So it actually disappears in your ceiling. Makes it way more interesting and easy to mount in your house without, well, hey, there is a screen. Okay, now with higher resolution projectors, of course, you have more pixels. So you also need screens that can show that resolution, right? Now, when you look at it on paper, you don't really see a difference between Ultra HD screen or a normal 1080 screen, but if you feel it, there's a huge difference in structure, and Projecta actually has a setup where you can actually feel the screens. And they actually also show it with a microscope. So you can see the different screen types under a microscope, and you can really see that that high resolution screen is totally different from a normal screen. Look at the difference. That's huge. And here you can actually feel the screens. And again, it's a totally different feeling experience. You can literally feel the resolution on your fingertips. Really cool to see that in one place next to each other. Okay, so what is the biggest problem when you project? The sun, right? Because it always wins from the projector. But there's also a solution for that, and that's actually called parallax with Projecta. And that is a screen that actually takes away the light from everything else than the projector. Sounds weird? Let me show you. Okay, so here you see the screen, and Enoik is now holding a white piece of paper in front of it. And as you can see, the blacks on the screen are way more intense. I hope you can see it on this video, but the blacks are way more intense on the screen and on the white piece of paper. It does take away some of the light, but let's be honest, if you have a lot of ambient light in your living room and you want to have home cinema, this is a really good solution. And it's also now available in motorized screens, so you don't need fixed screens for it anymore. It's called parallax. And of course, on a Dutch trade show, stroopwafels. Really bad food, really good food. And of course Sony is also on the ESA with their projectors and screens, of course. And also here a huge screen, brilliant colors and really, really sharp. I think in the future we need bigger houses, guys, because otherwise we can't fit our home entertainment system anymore. Another thing, of course, is that at this moment you need projection to get really large. And with the new OLED screens and screens like this, you don't really need projection anymore. So you have way more light output, great for HDR, and sharpness, oh my, it's really, really sharp. Awesome. Oh, and by the way, what you just saw is actually a video game. This is sick. Now, of course, you guys are also interested in video and photography, right? So how does a lens from a projector look? Well, they look a little bit different than from your camera. So let's take a look at some projector lenses. And here we have some optional lenses. And as you can see, they also have motor zoom, of course, for the projectors. Okay, and the game you're seeing now is Gran Turismo. And this screen is literally huge. So let me just show you how big it is. Those are the people next to it to give you a little bit of a scale. And it's razor, razor sharp. We actually thought it was video until we saw it was actually a video game. Absolutely stunning. I hope you guys can see how the screen is built up. Probably not, but it's all little tiles. They are very reflective. But it's all those little tiles that actually make up this great image. And from a distance, again, it absolutely looks stunning. Very close by, you can actually see the tiles, but it's way too reflective, so you don't see this on the video. But trust me, it's there. And as you can see here, it's actually a pretty high resolution. And some of the information off the screen. And again, on a distance, you don't see anything, so it's a seamless image. If you look really close by, you can see the tiles, but with this kind of screens, you don't stand close. And ever wondered how a really big motorized screen looked? Well, here we go. So this is one of the screens from ScreenInt. As you can see, it's a motorized screen. And this is normally, of course, for way bigger screens. It looks really heavy duty, so this will work just fine if you have larger screens. And this is actually, in case you guys don't know, this is acoustic transparent screen, so you can actually place speakers behind the screen. And it's one of the screens in their CinePro series. And ScreenInt is a really good manufacturer of screens, so if you're in the market for screens, make sure you check out ScreenInt. And if you're more into the tap tension screens, they also have solutions for that, of course. Like this one. And one of the main advantages, of course, of tap tension is that it's always, well, really nice. And there are no actual bubbles in the screen. Although in this screen you can see that there actually is. That's probably because it's not tensioned right. But normally these screens are totally flat, and that's great for watching movies. That's actually something I always advise people. If you want to use a projector, make sure you get a tap tensioned or a fixed screen, because the normal screens, it's not nice to see a car going from left to right and that this happens. So make sure that you get a screen that's actually always flat, and tap tensioned is a great solution for that. Oh yeah, you guys probably remember my Minority Report, right? Well, watch this. And as you can see, Anouk is great for that movie. She can even zoom in. Pretty cool to do. It even works with one hand, so you can do everything you want with the image and zoom in. If you're really close, you can see that there's a little bit of pixelation, but if you zoom in, it's really nice. Now, do you love music and do you want some hard-hitting bass for your garden? Well, look no further. It's really a good subwoofer here. Imagine having this in your garden. And of course, they don't forget the people with a small home who want a projector. Just kidding, of course, these are demo samples. They're really small. And because it always can be more extreme and bigger, Epson. Wow. A great idea if you have a limbo wall in your studio. Eat your heart out, IMAX. And now the cool thing, of course, is that everything is sharp, even if it's a bent area. So that's really nice to see. So normally you have to project on a flat screen, of course. And here everything is bent and it still keeps focus. Nice. And they're actually using 6 projectors for this. As you can see up there. So 3 up, 3 down. Now, of course, sometimes you don't have room for a projector and you need something that's really close by. They call that a short throw projector and they have some set up here. So as you can see, they're really close to the screen and they still give a tremendous amount of light and a really cool solution if you don't have enough space. And they even have it in portrait mode if you don't have any space on your ceiling. They thought of everything at Epson. And these are some of the laser solutions, and laser, of course, has a very big advantage. With a normal projector bulb, you can do maybe 2,000, 3,000 hours, and with a laser, it's of course way up to 20,000, and they don't lose the quality that a normal projector bulb does. So for educational parts, lasers are the future, or at least for now. And let's say that you don't want to aim your projector towards the screen, well, no problem. You just aim your projector, well, towards the screen. But the lens is actually the other way around here. So that saves a little bit of space, of course, for, well, mounting your projector. For example, for a museum or anything else. And of course, this is also a short throw projector. So there's a little bit of an, well, curved surface here. It's really nice and it looks really weird. Now, guys probably know I love exercising. I row, we do elliptical, and of course I bike. Now with bikes, I always tell people you have to go outside because inside, well, it's not that nice and outside it's great. But you also have bikes, of course, with screens. And then you can actually see where you bike. One bigger? No problem. It looks like a pretty cool screen, right? But that's not the screen. Look at this. This is actually the screen. So why go outside? Just stay inside with your bike. And of course, you want to watch your movie in total luxury, right? So you need special seats. Well, they're also at ISA. And yes, boys and girls, cup holders included. Makes me want to sit down. Now, of course, sometimes you also need something to eat, right? So you go into a restaurant. Wouldn't it be cool to see something on your plate that isn't there? Watch this. And I'm sorry for the flickering, guys, but I think you see what I mean. And of course, it can also work for menus. And of course, they use projectors on the ceiling to actually create this. So what happens if you hold your hand in front of it? Yeah, well, nothing's perfect. But of course, it doesn't stop there. You can also project in, let's say, an umbrella. Why not? Okay, we're now at the screen innovation booth, and these guys are still the king when it comes to screens that actually block ambient light and only show you the projector. Great for living rooms, boardrooms, or whatever, if you don't want to make it completely dark like a Batcave, which a good home cinema, of course, should be. But if you don't have that option, these screens are actually pretty good. Now, a few years ago, this wasn't possible because you wouldn't see any image because there's a lot of light hitting these screens. And now with these screens, it's actually possible. And one of their most famous screens is actually the Black Diamond. But then I also have screens that you can fold around the corner. Look at this. It's a rollable rear pro glass. Of course, you probably know BenQ from monitors, which I absolutely love, but of course they do a lot more. And on ESA, they're actually with a whole booth with some of their goodies. Now, why buy speakers if you can just put a piano in your house and let it play? Okay, we're at the Blackmagic booth, and one of the most interesting things I think is DaVinci Resolve. Now, it's a free editing software package. It's actually a pretty complete video editing software solution. So make sure you check them out if you're into video editing and you want something more than just the standard free stuff. DaVinci Resolve is actually pretty much a competitor to, for example, Final Cut Pro or Premiere. And the cool thing, it's totally free and it's awesome. Oh, and by the way, we love these keyboards from Logic. I use them myself. They're really good. And they also have them for Lightroom, Premiere, and of course a lot of other software solutions. But this one is of course for DaVinci Resolve. This gives a whole different meaning to go with the flow. So she can just move her arms, it seems, and it actually changes the images on the screen. Okay, that was a quick visit to the ISA. Now we have to get back to the bus and see if our car is still there undamaged. But first, I have to buy a parking card for 18 euros. It's a lot of money. Okay, hold your breath because you can't smoke inside anymore, so everybody smokes here. Ridiculous. So hold your breath while walking, getting a parking ticket. Just kidding. But it is absolutely disgusting. Okay, mission parking card succeeded. Now finding the bus to get back to the parking area. And it's something I did arrange perfectly because, well, having a bus picking you up and putting you right in front of the Rai is of course awesome. Come on. Hi. Nummer 11.
Number 2. P2.
And of course, you find them everywhere, the Tesla. Okay guys, if you like what we do, please subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, and of course smash that like button, because we really like that. And I hope you also like to see the other part of us. So not just photography, but also some other stuff. Thank you very much for watching guys, and see you again next time. Bye bye. Oh, and by the way, if you really like what we do on social media and YouTube, check out our Patreon, because Patreon makes everything possible that we do. See you next time. Bye bye.